If you like SuperMemo and incremental reading and you don't know this icon, you'll probably like this video. I want to speak about neural learning. It is like incremental learning, but better. You don't need to plan, design, add outstanding, create subsets, interleave, prioritize, sort, nothing. It's just automatic and pretty intelligent. I would like to learn about nature versus nurture dilemma. With C, I jump to my concept box. Nature versus nurture. I'll go to the root element. With control space, I'll open all the descendants of the concept. And by the way, it's a part of personality, psychology, and brain structure. That this structure will be important in neural review. So I'll press control space. Each time in review, you might be tempted to press randomize because you don't want to have learning as it goes. Usually gets very boring very fast, and efficiency and inspiration also dropping. But you could just press neural review and all the sorting would be done for you. And here we have the first topic. It's Oliver James, an interesting personality. Before I start reading, I already have an idea. We can split that article. We don't need those external links, references, seals, reference, attention. Oh, maybe that's gonna stay. Now we'll go back to the root. Control up arrow, Oliver James. Control space again. And now, while being a neural review, I want to add this portion to neural review too. And perhaps with higher priority, so that the exposure to those elements will be a bit higher in reference to the main body of review. So I'll press neural review again. But this time it asks me if I want to start new review or I want to add it to the presently used review. And I want to add it to what I'm doing now. So, okay, what priority? I think Oliver James is important because he got pretty unusual theory, so that's always an inspiration. Let's give him the priority 3. Mind, philosopher mind, that's not what I want to study. I'm not even sure why. It's nature versus nurture. Daniel Dennett. Oh yeah, nature versus nurture. Give me a dozen healthy infants, well-formed, and my own specified world to bring them up, and I'll guarantee to take anyone at random and train him to become any type of specialist I may select, doctor, lawyer, artist, merchant. Yeah, even bigger man and thief, regardless of his talent, pensions, tendencies, abilities, vocations. John Watson. Wow. So I'll need to read about John Watson too. I'll quickly check if I already have him in my collection. I do. So with control double click, I'll go there. It's under behaviorism. That's correct. But no problem. I go to the root, control up arrow again, control space to open it, and again, add to my review. Again with high priority. To this topic, I set very high priority, position 3. It will affect further review. Even if this element is eliminated, disposed of, its descendants will be neighbors of other elements, and due to their high priority, they will have increasing chances of getting into the review. The nature side of the debate emphasizes how much of knowledge reflects biological factors. Yeah, that's fantastic. Yeah. Serotonin transporter gene. It's called this inherited genetic happiness gene. It's prominent. Wow. So what will I do? I'll search the collection for a serotonin transport gene. Not much. 53 elements. And again, add to review at high priority. serotonin transported gene. Alright, I have an item about it. Stressful life events. Chronic stress, trauma, adverse childhood experiences can lead to epigenetic changes such as increased DNA methylation at the 5-HTLPR region, serotonin transport link polymorphic region. Okay. Serotonin also reduces expression of transport. Serotonin transport are linked to alternative serotonin in the brain. Social environment. Burke says that experiment with Little Albert inspired Watson's emphasis on environmental factors. Little Albert didn't fear the red and white rabbit until he was conditioned to do so. Yeah, this is how neuroticism is born. From this experiment, Watson concluded that parents can shape a child's behavior and develop simply by skimming control and all stimulus response associations. Epigenetic modifications such as DNA methylation. Previous research has found evidence that most adults become more agreeable, more conscientious, and less neurotic as they age. True. Called maturation effect. Let's leave it for a while. Ah, I think it came back. The nature side of this debate emphasizes how much of an organism reflects biological factors, but on the other hand, genes are activated at appropriate times during development or the base of protein production. Proteins include a wide range. When looking at the influence of genes in the nature versus nurture debate, there has been found to be variation in the promoter region of the serotonin transporter gene. The discovery of this inherited genetic happiness gene is promising evidence for the nature side of the debate when measuring satisfaction. Yeah, that's critical. The nurture side, on the other hand, emphasizes how much of an organism reflects environmental factors. In reality, it is most likely interaction of both genes and environment and nature. Mental contents are those items that are thought of being in the mind and capable of being formed and manipulated by mental processes or faculties. Examples include thoughts, concepts, memories. Boring. Why is this mind so high here? Evidence that supports the genetic defense stems includes Brunner's 1993 discovery of what is known as Brunner's syndrome and a series of studies on mice. Interesting. Proponents of the defense suggest that an individual cannot be held accountable for their genes, as a result, should not be held responsible for their dispositions, resulting actions. If a single gene mutation is the reason for aggressive behavior, there is a possibility aggressive offenders will have a genetic excuse for their crimes. As I keep going, this neurocue might be increasing in size, still very small. But SuperMemo at each review is looking for new elements. So when I go to the next one, oh, this time it got smaller. Wisdom. What's wisdom doing here? Okay, let's say it's misplaced. Psychology, boring again. Scientific approach also seeks to break down variance beyond those two categories of nature and nurture. That's rather than nurture behavior, genetics, and non-shared factors. Discourse. Heritability. I need missing heritability, something very important is gonna be missing heritability. Search the collection. Not much material. High priority. The Q grew to 194. It's one of the central problems of the field, the agenda of future research. missing heredity. The term refers to the gap between the high heritability estimates from twin family studies and the much lower variance explained by specific genetic markers. Identifying molecular studies, this issue is significant. Yeah. Innatism. Philosophical epistemological doctrine, how the mind is born with ideas, knowledge, and therefore the mind is not a blank state at birth, as early empiricists such as John Locke claimed. Okay. I don't see no name. Locke. Leibniz. Yeah, that's interesting. How split is an additive review? Same procedure, split, get rid of the garbage, up, control space, add to review, perhaps with not so high priority, 20, 30, genetics of late onset AD, Alzheimer's, Adam. So I have to schedule for tomorrow. That's not good for the video. Good. Let's learn. Leibniz suggests that we are born with certain innate ideas. Mathematical truisms. The idea that 1 plus 1 equals 2 is evident to us without the necessity for empirical evidence. Not exactly. Babies need to learn that. Gottfried, you were wrong. John Locke, the main a contemporary of Leibniz. Locke argued that the mind is, in fact, devoid of all knowledge or ideas at birth. It's a blank sheet, a tabula rasa. Does he say anything specific, interesting, some evidence? The theory of innate knowledge is excessive. Even innate is accepted that most of our knowledge is learned through experience. Yet ideas are universally held. Do we all possess the idea of God? Even there are some universally agreed statements that the ability of the human mind to organize, yeah, makes sense. Heritability. And I'll repeat the procedure. That's too important. Maybe I'll add some pictures. Idea. Heritability. Split, delete garbage, control space, and add to neural review, perhaps with a bit lower priority. Tabula rasa in computer science. Oh, Alpha Zero achieves superhuman performance in various board games using self-playing and tabula rasa reinforcement learning. Meaning it had no access to human games and hardcore human knowledge about their game. Yeah, that's good evidence. That's probably PDF import. It's messed up a bit. Abstract. This study is the similar issue of the concept of heritability to give an introduction to behavioral genetics theory methods as well as to give an overview of the current knowledge about heritability, personality, quantity, morality. Okay, it's interesting. I'll schedule for tomorrow. A higher priority. Spawn. Nurture assumption. Julie Heritage is a nurture. It's traditionally defined as terms of family. A brain does not effectively explain the variance of most traits such as IQ. Oh, that's a problem. In the general population of the United States, on the contrary, suggests that either peer groups or random environmental beings, those that are in a family, are more important than family environmental effects. That's a big deal. That's also nurture. Judith Harris. Adoption studies indicate that by adulthood, adoptive siblings, not related by blood, are no more similar in IQ than strangers. IQ correlation near 0. While full siblings show an IQ correlation of 0.6. Heritability refers to the origins of differences between people. The variability of trait can be meaningfully spoken of as attuned to Huntington's disease. And the other extreme traits, such as native language, at a molecular level, genes interact with signals from other genes and from the environment. While there are many thousands of single gene locus traits, so-called complex traits are due to the added effects of many, hundreds of small gene effects. A good example is height. So genetic and environmental conditions can predominate in rare circumstances. If a child is born mute due to a genetic mutation, it will not learn to speak any language. Wow. Retovese. Two buckets versus homogeneous mud pie. Search for pinker. This could be a rich but low priority. So search the collection for pinker. Add pinker to review, but at low priority. On the other hand, by late adolescence, this correlation disappears, such that adoptive siblings no longer have similar IQ scores. Yeah, very interesting. Okay. The Q grew up to 597 elements, and if I want to get rid of it and just resume normal learning, I just press escape, and learning begins. Hold still. Don't move.
Don't move.